In 3 days, the Baylor Bears will open the NCAA tournament against the Hartford Hawks. And in just their first game as a number one seed in the NCAA tournament, the Bears will try to avoid becoming just the second team in that top spot to lose in the round of 64. Baylor and Hartford will meet in the same building that's set to host the Final Four at the end of the month. To make sure they advance in the bracket for the third straight trip to the NCAA tournament, the Bears will have to focus on one thing: themselves.
When it comes to the NCAA tournament, everybody's good, everybody's talented, but usually the teams that make it to March have great guard play, and they do. No matter what region you're ever in, there's going to be a lot of good and talented and teams with a lot of history, tradition. So it's one of those things in March. Everyone loves it because it's a 40-minute game. Anybody can win in that 40 minutes.
Baylor and Hartford will face off on day one of the first round at 2:30 tip Friday afternoon. The AP All-America rosters were released today, and Baylor had quite the presence. No surprise here. Jared Butler named to the first team after averaging 17.1 points per game on the way to Baylor's first conference title in 71 years. Davion Mitchell, who averaged more than 14 points and almost 8 rebounds a game, was named to the third team. Macy Oteague received honorable mention honors. Well, the Lady Bears are in San Antonio for the first of they don't know how many nights for the NCAA tournament, which starts in 5 days. Now, here's the weird thing. Baylor, after a strong showing in Kansas City, somehow dropped a couple of spots, winding up in the same region as UConn. The Lady Bears will have to pass a couple of tests in the Riverwalk region to get back to the Elite Eight, but right now they're not focused on that. They're just excited to be back on the court for another NCAA tournament after last year's was canceled.
I know Moon and I were extremely excited that it was going to be in New Orleans last year because that's our home state. And we were going to fight over the number of tickets that each of us was going to need. Staying home in Texas is a good thing. It's good for the state. It's good for women's basketball in our state. You just wish there was not a limit on the number of people who could see it.
The reigning national champs open with Jackson State on Sunday afternoon inside the Alamo Dome in San Antonio. Troy ISD has officially announced who its new head football coach and athletic director will be this fall. Stephen Hermsmeyer will take over a Trojans program that is only 2 seasons removed from its longest ever playoff run. Hermsmeyer spent the past 9 seasons in the same position at Comanche. He went 61-42 in that time and had a 4-year stint at Winters before that. On the diamond, the red-hot Baylor Bears hosting UTSA in midweek baseball action tonight. First inning, Dylan Rock with one on and one out. He crushes one to left center field. That one lands in the Brazos, gives the Roadrunners a 2-0 lead. Then, in the Baylor half, it's Trey Richardson with a rocket-launched grounder down the first baseline. One run scores. Bears trail by just one. Next batter is Andy Thomas. Deep fly ball to left field. It one-hops the wall off the track. Richardson scores. That's part of a 5-run first inning. Bears win and host Prairie View A&M tomorrow. Softball at home tonight, too, hosting Stephen F. Austin in midweek action. Top of the first, and Gio Radoni, hot right out of the gate, gets the swing and a miss for strike three. Lady Bears are out of the inning. In the Baylor half, it's Aaliyah Benford with a grounder to second. She's out, but Nikki Dawson scores. Lady Bears are on the board. Lady Jacks tie it up later. Baylor gets the win, 3-2 the final. That's it for sports. 6 News at 10. We'll be right back.